Oh, they lost. Now they got to bounce back here tonight against against LaSalle. What do you make of the matchup?
We've all had nightmares in our life. The LaSalle backcourt will have nightmares of Briante Weber after this game. Havoc returns at the Siegel Center.
Not a good night to be LaSalle walking into a tough spot.
They score. They give up a lot of points. VCU does on our network. So let's see whether or not
Steve
they're in the 80s.
Is
the
a defense. Resident of Philadelphia. We want to point that out.
All right. Send it out to Brad Johansson for LaSalle VCU. We are back at halftime.
Welcome to the Stuart Siegel Center in Richmond, Virginia. The Explorers of LaSalle here to take on the Rams of VCU. This game brought to you in high definition by LG. Hello again, everyone. Brad Johansson alongside Steve Wolf, courtside. You are joining us after one of the top teams have fallen in the A-10. Xavier, a 59-49 loser at St. Joe's. Things are topsy-turvy here.
They really are, and this is the best the A-10 has been in the 10 years I've been covering. 16 teams with the addition of VCU and Butler. This is a great league.
Both these two teams involved here were involved in upsets this week. LaSalle took down number 9 Butler on Wednesday. On Thursday, VCU dropped by Richmond in overtime. Dr. John Giannini says that win doesn't mean a whole lot unless we continue to do it throughout this season and take it into March as you take a look at the Explorers lineup tonight.
Well, you look at it, this is a guard oriented lineup. Duren, Mills, and Galloway, three solid guards, and in the backcourt you have DJ Peterson coming in for Steve Zach. Zach, a big 7-footer, and then you have Jarrell Wright, who's the only big man in the starting lineup for LaSalle.
And the VCU Rams, you talk about the guards, they've got plenty of them.
They really do. Theus is their leader. He's the straw that stirs the drink. Brandenburg and Daniels is the shooter. Then you have Graham, who's maybe the player of the year in the A-10, and Juvonte Reddic, which I think he is the guy that makes these guys go down low.
He may be a next level guy, and this guy has taken it to another level. Got his 100th win against Duquesne earlier, and looking for 101 tonight. The second youngest coach at 35 to reach 100 behind Brad Stevens, and we are ready to get underway. LaSalle in blue, VCU in the home white. And the Explorers will have first possession.
VCU will extend that defense, and when they get the ball, and LaSalle gets the ball in the corner, they'll trap anytime they have a sideline or a baseline.
Duren blocked. Theus got it out of bounds. It will stay with the Explorers. It is havoc to begin with. They create it on defense. They turn it into offense. Better than anyone in the country.
Yeah, they get 32% of their offense off of turnovers, about 25 points a game. And that's not a turnover, but it will give LaSalle to make a timeout. Take a timeout.
Take a look at our keys to the game. LaSalle and VCU atop the A-10.
You look at LaSalle, they are guard-oriented, but playing against this havoc defense. They have to take care of the ball, and they have to rebound. VCU, because they were slowed down by Richmond on Thursday, they need to create that tempo, create more turnovers. And I really think that they have to go to Graham and Reddic early in the game and establish an inside presence.
Dr. John Giannini says that what he's got to do is keep his team under control. Cannot turn it over, and when they do, cannot let them score off those turnovers.
That shoot around today, Brad, as you saw, he had a shirt on that said, "I hate turnovers." I said, "Let's get that on camera." He goes, "No, I don't want anybody to see my body in this shirt." Although he is now looking pretty stealth over there on the sidelines.
Doctor of kinesiology. Galloway down to Duren. Overcooked it, right the rebound. Blocked as he goes back up, jump ball call. And that possession will go to VCU.
I like what they did. Galloway got the ball off the dribble in the middle of the court, and then they were able to get a shot at the basket and also an offensive rebound, right? Just wasn't able to get the stick back.
Brandenburg down to Graham. He had that blocked by Wright and saved to Galloway.
It's good defense by Wright, not jumping, but putting his hand straight up.
Looking low on the block to Wright. Working on Daniels, got his own rebound. Knocked away by Theus, will stay with LaSalle.
When you watch VCU practice, they practice so hard. anytime they're in a defensive end, the hands are moving. Wherever the ball is, you'll see three defenders.
Double teamed out top is Galloway. And he's got to call another timeout. Their second in less than a minute and a half.
I'll tell you, when VCU comes out with excitement and adrenaline like they are right now at home, very hard to play offensive again. You'll see Galloway over there on the side, and then you'll see Reddick come over and all of a sudden just get him at the half-court line. You see it when any time you see a line on the court, they're able to trap, whether it's a half-court line, whether it's a sideline or a baseline, that's what they're looking to trap you and turn you over.
Use it as an extra man.
Absolutely.
Shaka Smart said that he liked the way his team responded after Thursday's loss to Richmond. They came out full and ready to go on Friday practice. You see the Havoc defense, they lead the country in steals and in turnover margin.
And in that Thursday game, they weren't able to control tempo and therefore didn't turn Richmond over. They think they turned Richmond over 13 times. They usually turn teams over 21 times.
And another tie-up. Brandenburg got this one. The possession arrow will go with the Explorers.
We'll see it again. You pick your dribble up in a trap, you're in trouble. You have to make sure you move the ball quick against this defense. It's man-to-man, but these guys are athletic, and they come back and they trap very well.
10 on the shot clock. Duren on Brandenburg, into the paint. Off balance, had it blocked, got it up again. And the first and four shots to go for the Explorers.
LaSalle trying to get that ball in the middle. That's two times they've been able to drive in the paint and get something going to the basket.
Brandenburg with the left hand, laid it short. Down low, right easy.
Boy, that was set up by Tyreek Duren, and that was an excellent cut by Wright to the basket. He slipped the screen and went straight in for two. Three straight times able to get the ball in the middle of the court against this VCU Havoc defense.
Wright, the sophomore out of Philly. 6'8", 240, big body down low. He's on Reddick, and the Explorers turn them over. Galloway with the left.
Uncharacteristic of VCU's team defense. No help in the lane on that one. And now you see LaSalle pressing VCU. VCU has got to get the ball into Graham and Reddick's hands.
A 6-0 start for the team that upset Butler on Wednesday. Looking to do it again. Down low, easy to Reddick. Somebody missed an assignment.
That was exactly what happened on the other end of the court to Wright. Somebody slipped the screen. You saw a beautiful cut to the basket by Reddick.
Mills has it knocked away by Theus. Graham into Reddick again. Duren races to the other end. Right? The easy give to Sam Mills.
You're watching two very unselfish teams right here. That was a great pass by Graham, and another one as Mills is cut to the basket.
Theus with the oop to Reddick. Six straight for 15. Almost. And they got it. Darius Theus, you talk about active hands. He has been all over the floor in the early going.
Theus went airborne for that ball. And I'll tell you, watch the hustle here. Great pass to Reddick. But then on the inbounds pass, you always have to find out where Theus is.
Third turnover for LaSalle.
I think the biggest difference between VCU and most other teams that play good defense is they convert on the turnovers. They do a good job of finishing at the other end once they turn you over.
They got two off that from Graham. And almost got one more.
Look at Shaka Smart. How about that? He's got his gym shoes on, but even if he didn't, he had dress shoes, he'd be down there picking up his teammate, Weber.
LaSalle started with the first 6-8-2 run by the Rams to knot it at 8. Briante Weber, the sophomore out of Chesapeake, in for his first minutes. He's on Duren. Duren to the lane, foul on Weber. Almost had it knocked away.
Weber comes off the bench and averages 3 steals a game. Guy is quick. A lot of energy in this building.
Shaka Smart has havoc rolling. We're not at an 8.
I was one of those guys who didn't think the Army had anything for me. Then I found out that less than 0.1% of all Americans wear the uniform of an Army officer. It's a small group of us, but we're among the most highly educated compared to many other corporations or institutions. I was surprised at what I found in being an officer and at what the Army helped bring out of me. I'm Major Miles B. Kaggins III, Officer, United States Army.
Find a stronger future as an officer at goarmy.com/officer. There's strong, then there's Army strong.
And done.
Did you just turn your ringer off so no one would interrupt us?
No. I just used my Geico app to get a tow truck. It's gonna be here in 30 minutes.
Oh, so that means we won't be stuck up here for hours with nothing to do.
I get it. You wanna pass the time, huh?
Fruit Ninja.
Emergency roadside assistance. Just a click away with the Geico mobile app.
Come on, kid. I'm Drew Brees.
And I'm Harry.
Who?
From One Direction.
Dudes, won the Super Bowl.
Platinum album.
MVP.
On the cover.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Hey, man. Give me the Pepsi, and I'll get you a tryout.
Cool.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here. By the U.S. Postal Service. Schedule your free package pickup today. And by Ram Trucks. Designed, tested, and proven to be the best trucks we've ever built. Ram.
Fans ready to go. Trying to get to 5-0 are the VCU Rams. LaSalle trying to pull its second upset of the week. And here's what happened in the A-10 today. How about that? Almost a 30-point victory for George Washington over Charlotte. Butler gets the win over Temple. And Xavier, as we said, falls to St. Joe.
Yeah, it's really hard to pick who is the leader. You can look at the stats, but earlier today, Charlotte was the first place team, and you saw what happened to them losing the GW. Coach Lonergan's got those guys playing, the 4 freshmen and a transfer starting in that lineup.
We're in for an interesting conference run all the way through March.
Well, that was interesting. John Giannini, who is very creative, did a put Zach, a 7-footer, running into backcourt to get that out of bounds play.
Weber on the break. Had it knocked away by Garland, they'll call the foul on Garland, the transfer out of Virginia Tech.
I tell you what, Weber is very, very quick. We were amazed today at the shoot-around. They said he's got a 48-inch vertical jump, so I was actually interested to see what he'd do on this fast break, but Garland came over and stopped him from getting the easy two. Smart play by Garland.
You heard Steve Wright.
Yeah.
48-inch vertical jump. He came in with a 45.5-inch vertical jump, so I don't know whether it's going to get even larger than that. I can't even imagine.
Well, you heard what Shaka Smart said. Did you see LaSalle out on a 2-3 zone? Shaka Smart said he's quick, he can jump, he's a great kid. Needed to shoot a little bit better. There's always, coaches are always looking for the angle.
Corner. Daniels, his 31st straight game with a 3.
Daniels is their best shooter, their best 3-point threat.
Duren in the lane, off balance, he's fouled and will go to the line.
Well, I tell you, that trap in the corner, Galloway coming up the court, got the ball in the middle to be able to get Duren to the basket, but it's amazing to see these guys in person from VCU, how quick they are on the perimeter and how well they disguise their traps. As soon as you turn your back, they're going to trap you.
Graham with the foul. Duren makes the first. Take a look at the A-10 standings and why LaSalle has to get a win today.
Yeah, you just look at that. That's going to change week in and week out, Brad, because VCU has a tough five-game schedule. And so does LaSalle. You beat a monster, and then you have a monster coming into your own house, is what John Giannini said.
Duren makes them both. Weber off on his three try. Reddic the rebound, and it is off Galloway. We'll stay with the Rams.
Interesting so far, we haven't seen a lot of three-point field goal attempts. We've only seen a total of three in the first 6 minutes.
Theus out top with Galloway on him. That big man you talked about, Zach, in the middle now.
He usually starts, but Zach Giannini decided to get a smaller rotation in there to keep up with the quickness.
Nice job on the glass. Explorers coming the other way. Duren up and under.
Duren went right between two defenders and had a little spin on there to get that layup to go in there. VCU has got to stop that dribble penetration. I like what LaSalle's doing. They're being aggressive and taking it to the basket.
Duren now with six, and they've quieted the crowd to take a one-point lead. Knocked away again. Take a look at Duren on the run.
You're talking about beating pressure. You have to get the ball in the middle. Duren just keeps on going down the lane. Theus does not step over, which is probably a smart move to take the charge because he wouldn't have gotten it. But Duren is a very, very quick player. And he's a born scorer.
You talked about it at the outset, guards against guards. They are overloaded on both sides. Quick hands, quick feet all night long.
Haley's in the game. Big guy down low, guarding Zach for VCU.
Johnson, Steve, with the air ball. So VCU on defense, trying to create havoc, can't get it done. Tyrone Garland to the glass. They're getting to the glass early.
They are doing a great job of getting in the middle of the court, and that's exactly where you have to get to beat pressure.
6-0 run for the Explorers. What you expected from VCU after a loss?
Well, I tell you, they look like they got a hop in their step, but they're not finishing on the offensive end, and they're not stopping the ball. You have to stop it right now. You can't wait.
Garland to Durant. Duren now with eight.
They're not stopping the ball early enough. You'll see right here, the Johnson tried to stop Garland. Nobody was back to help get the second man down court. The first guy down gets the ball. The second guy gets a cutter. Nobody's helping out. LaSalle, right now, the aggressor in the early going.
Duren now with half of the Explorers' points. And completes the three-point play.
Doc Giannini doesn't want us talking about the Butler win, but it was a great win for the A-10 and for the program at LaSalle, because it shows that the A-10 is solid, but this LaSalle team has been good for a couple years now, and they are now showing people outside of the A-10 how good they are.
And we've got a foul. Wright chasing the loose ball with Melvin Johnson will get called for that one. Struggling to get off shots and can't get it to fall. 0 for their last four are the Rams.
You know, in the Richmond game, Treveon Graham did not score in the first half. And he needs to get involved in the game. They have to find a way. That is really Brandenburg and Theus' job to get Graham involved in the game.
There is Graham, and he walked. So another turnover for the Rams. Take a look at it again.
Well, he hasn't touched the ball in a while, and he picked up his left foot. as he was cutting to the basket. This is one of the best scores in the A-10. He is, can score inside, outside. Didn't score against Richmond in the first half, but ended up with a double-double, 15 and 10.
Galloway, Theus on him. Garland out top. Runs with Graham. Off the glass, can't get the roll. Graham the other way. Brandenburg has it blocked. Galloway went up high. The Explorers are getting it done. Tyreek Duren with 9 points. And VCU struggling to score, down 6 in the early going.
It was designed to escape the ordinary. It feels like it can escape gravity. The 2013 C-Class Coupe. Starting at $37,800.
Action. Cut.
Yeah, we're gonna need another wall. What's the number for props?
Take a note, make a call, all on the same screen. LG Optimus G.
Relax.
Available on AT&T.
How does an investment manager build portfolios to stand the test of time? At Franklin Templeton, 60 years of investing through every kind of market has taught us to manage risk as vigilantly as we seek reward. This solid approach has made us a leading equity fund manager. Franklin Templeton Investments. Gain from our perspective. Ask your advisor for a fuller summary prospectus with investment goals, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
A 9-0 run for LaSalle over the last 3:01 has them up by 6, led by one of the members of the Pride of Philadelphia.
And you got Duren right here in the middle, 14.4 points a game, but he has taken over with 9 points in this first half. And Brad, what he's doing is getting to the basket. So far, LaSalle has been more aggressive than the havoc on offense and defense by VCU.
Their top four scorers all from Philly. We talked about Garland, who went to Virginia Tech. Didn't like the way things were going there and said the only way he would do it would come back home. And this was a place that he trusted. And he has been a significant factor for Dr. John.
Yeah, I've had a lot of time to talk to the academic advisor, Christine Cahill, who told me that the one thing about John Giannini is he tells these guys the truth. And that's exactly what Garland said. I want somebody who's going to be honest with me. And that's one thing Dr. Giannini is. He's a heck of a coach, but he's a quality guy.
Rams have missed their last 7. Reddick trying to cash in and finally ends the drought. He has been their offense in the early going.
That's the only way you get this LaSalle team beat on the defensive end, because they're smaller. You got to go after the Achilles heel, which is getting the ball inside in the paint.
Reddick with 8. Galloway from deep, in and out, won't go. Daniels with a rebound and coming the other way.
See if VCU does the same thing, trying to get the ball inside to the bigs. Exactly what they do. That's a foul down low, but that was, when you look at point guard play, Theus, the first recruit ever by Shaka Smart. He's a guy that takes over, dribble penetration, could have taken it to the lane and tried to score, but instead dishes it off. Very unselfish play. And not a bad foul by Zach, because that was a point break.
He got a lot of ball shot.
Yeah, but he got him on the arm there. That's a smart move by Reddick.
Reddick's 9th point of the evening. He had 20 against Richmond, a double-double to go with 10 rebounds, 6 of 7 from the floor, and 8 of 11 from the free throw line, and they'd love to get him to the free throw line 11 times every night.
If they do that, that means they're getting the ball in the paint, and that is good for VCU's outside jump shooting, too.
Back within two. Threw it away. Galloway too hard to Duren.
And that was another good defensive play because Theus got his hand in there and tipped it. Duren not able to grab it. It's important right now for LaSalle to maintain that poise because as soon as VCU ties this game, they have a chance to. The crowd's going to be back in it.
Sixth turnover on the Explorers. Reddic one more time. He's got a dozen.
Right to the middle. That's a great pass and a smart move by Zach using the backboard as a shield to go up and lay it in with his right hand.
Seven-footer showing a little athleticism. Knocked away by Galloway. Will stay with the Rams.
You talk about resiliency. You know, VCU resilient after that loss at Richmond. LaSalle, I like the fact that they give up a set. It was 17-11. VCU ties it at 17. They come down and do what you're supposed to do. Get the ball in the middle and get an easy bucket. Showing poise.
Corner. Theus. High arcing shot won't go. Peterson. The rebound.
And that's really what LaSalle wants. They want VCU to keep the ball on the outside, as you see.
No basket. That's charging on Garland.
Reddic is down. He got hit in the nose.
Number 21, Tyreek Garland. Whistle for the player control foul. That is his second.
Take one more look.
You talk about defense. This is how you keep people out of the paint. And Reddic offered up his body, but that's how you're going to stop. And you'll see he was outside of the lane. See that circle, a half circle down there? If he would have been behind, underneath that, that would have been a block.
He caught Garland's elbow right in the nose. Stays in. Reddic again, feeling it.
He is just so much more athletic. Probably the most athletic player on the floor right now. But he's quicker than Zach. Not as big, but he's very mobile. And able to get that little 5-6 foot jump shot.
He's got 14, 6'9", 235. Galloway trying to answer. Daniels the rebound. Deep. Daniels. Three-point lead for the Rams. Galloway on the run. Mills for three to answer. That won't go. Reddic the rebound. Ahead to Graham. Had it knocked away by Mills. They're going the other way. Garland for three. Reddic the rebound.
That is not what John Giannini wants. Doc Giannini wants that ball inside. You can't get an up and down battle with VCU. They're really good at it. You got to try to take the ball in the lane. Get the ball in the paint. Get some easy buckets.
An 11-2 run for the Rams. Trying to add to that. Johnson in the paint. The one-handed floater short. Galloway coming back. That's way off. Zach the rebound. The tip won't go and Daniels got it.
Galloway's got a pump fake and drive it to the basket. Taking too many outside shots right now. And you're going to see if Graham gets into the show right now, there's going to be problems for the Explorers.
Explorers have missed their last five. An 11-2 run led by Reddic. He's got 14 early points. And then Daniels going deep. Three-point lead, Rams.
Thanks for the ticket, man.
Thanks to my State Farm agent for saving me $480.
No sweat. Hey, look, we're on fan cam.
Y'all ready for this?
Having the extra cash sure helps.
And I can save even more by combining your auto and renter's policies.
Cool. Well, what if we bought a house.
Auto and home? We have even bigger savings for that.
Wow, sounds good.
More savings any way you shake it.
Want to spit some nachos?
Sure.
Get to a better state. State Farm.
We didn't always watch football at Buffalo Wild Wings.
Let's do this.
Protect the football. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
V-twin power and torque. Maximum capability and versatility. And comfortable seating for four. The off-road rated Terex 4 side-by-side. How can it get any better? How about no interest for 48 months or a $1,000 purchase incentive? Better. Right now, get no interest for 48 months or a $1,000 purchase incentive on all Terex 4s. Don't wait. This offer ends March 31st.
The Rams are looking angry. An 11-2 run. They're up by three in Richmond. Brad Johansson alongside Steve Wolf. We've got a good one going, a little havoc running. What do you have?
Well, we really do. It was interesting watching practice today. Shaka Smart made sure he did drills when they were breaking the press. They have this heavy ball. You can buy these. These are great for kids, but they're a little bit heavier, so you have it really helps your hands get stronger when you're trying to take it away. Break, come on, buddy. That's how you break the press.
This is a break the press practice?
Well, you can use it. This is one of the things. It's a little bit heavier, and it's something that one of the techniques that Shaka Smart uses to coach with these kids. And, you know, he works. His strength and conditioning coach, Daniel Roos, is just outstanding. I mean, these guys preseason do Navy SEAL training. I mean, they are always looking at, you know, doing something different. I think Shaka Smart this morning was doing an MMA practice.
A little mixed martial arts?
They go kickboxing. I mean, it's the way they play, they have to be in shape. And I think that what Shaka Smart wants, he wants his team to be tough.
He's got some tough kids. Reddick, one of those. Or maybe the best kickboxer they have. He says, Reddick can do so many different things. He says, we got him in here. And he says, when we've got our kickboxing trainer, I said, if I get this kid for 6 months, nobody will want to fight him.
Well, nobody want to play defense against him either, because he's very good when he gets that ball within 15 feet of the basket.
He's taking a rest right now. Galloway from deep and drains it.
That's big. Galloway, the leading scorer on this team with 16 a game.
He's got four now. That one comes up short and right the rebound. And they got a foul. This one on Guest.
Well, you see Guest was pushing him out with his body.
Trying to use that line?
Absolutely. Always using it. What they do is they trap so well. You see them, they don't use their hands. They show their hands, you know, and that's so important. You watch Kraft from Ohio State. He uses his body, shows his hands so the referee sees. I'm not grabbing them, but they are very, very strong in their core from all the workout they do. They're hard to beat if they get you out around that half-court line.
Another foul out by the half court line. This one on Daniels.
That's his first. The Rams 15
foul on VCU. Theus on Duren. Daniels with Mills. Floater got the roll. And we're all tied up again. Explorers aren't going away.
They're getting the ball. When they get the ball in the lane, they're doing great. It's the problem is when they start relying on the three, they get problems.
Extra shots down on the floor. Duren the other way. Got Peterson ahead, and he finishes.
That was a super heads-up play by Duren, looking up court and getting Peterson. Peterson was basket hanging.
LaSalle back in front by two. Daniels threw it away. Peterson with Mills, and he'll lay it in.
I love that. Really unselfish play by Peterson. That's two straight easy buckets now for LaSalle.
Shaka Smart wants to talk it over. An 8-0 run from the Explorers.
Well, we knew we were going to have a solid game. There's great guard play, and the big guys run the floor for both teams. And that really is what you're seeing right now, the ebb and flow. It's like a boxing match.
You mentioned that Dr. John says, I don't want to continue to talk about this Butler thing because we're a good team. I didn't expect us to come in and get blown out by Butler. I'm not shocked that we beat Butler. One against Villanova earlier in the year, a team that took down Syracuse today. This is a strong squad that he says, we're good right now. We want to be great by March.
And they've been good the last 4 years. The problem is, and he wouldn't like me saying this, but he had some personnel a couple of years ago that just didn't mesh. And it was very, very hard. They had good personnel, but they didn't have the chemistry. Now he's got his guys, and I think that Duren really is the straw that stirs his drink. What a great kid, and everybody else follows him. As you see, LaSalle, believe it or not, leading the fast break point category.
You don't see that very much at VCU. Reddick high post, Brandenburg. Plenty of room for the jumper, it wouldn't go down.
One and done, too. TCU not getting any second chance baskets.
Peterson steps in, had it blocked. Wright gathers, back to Galloway for three.
You can't give him that, especially after he hit his first one a couple other possessions ago. Now Galloway streaking.
He's got seven.
Look for Reddick to be getting the ball on the low block.
Brandenburg, nice. That's way off.
Reddick had right on his back. Got to look at getting the big guy the ball.
Garland on the drive and the dish. Right, Reddick on him, backs him down, turns inside and walks.
Typically, when you have to make that many moves as a big man, you better throw it back out, get it back and reset. The guards on LaSalle look to get the ball inside, so just reset it, get it back in and let him have another shot at it, but too many moves by Wright on the low block.
Rams down seven, they've missed their last five shots. Find the offense that has disappeared.
Johnson did a good job against Richmond in the first half, creating. Johnson, number 32, out of New York. Got some great moves. See the turnover by VCU.
The last field goal came 5 minutes ago.
You got to credit LaSalle's defense. They are really scrappy, and they're trying to eliminate anything in the paint.
Galloway off the glass. The bank is open.
When things go right, they go right. That's a 14-0 run for the Explorers. And Galloway, he just went down court like he meant it was supposed to happen. But this is an NBA three, a step back off the glass.
It got a little more quiet in here, but I still didn't hear him call glass on that one.
You know, he's a character, too. I mean, he's shooting around early today. I threw in the ball and he missed a shot and I said, what do you want me to do? Do 3-2-1 so you make it? He's just a funny guy. Did you check the three-point field goals out? We knew it wouldn't be a three-point field goal game. More penetrating the lane, but so far, you know, LaSalle has 22 points in the paint as opposed to VCU that only has 14, and that is the key so far.
14-0 run. Galloway now with 10. Over the last 3:32, and it's been 4.5 since VCU has put one in the hoop.
This is Theus time right now. He's the coach on the court. He's got to make some things happen, whether it's dribble penetration, getting Graham and Reddick involved in the game. Reddick should be looked at every time down court.
Rams are the top scoring team in the A-10. They average 79. With 3.5 to go, they've got 23. Theus with a clear pass.
Well, they look to him. He's the guy, maybe not the leading scorer. You know, but he's the guy that they look to for a big, big push, a big shot, a big play.
3:30 to play in the first half. LaSalle looking to do it again.
Get ready for a four-day weekend of college hoops action. The 2013 Buick Atlantic 10 Men's Basketball Championships is heading to Barclays Center. Don't miss the excitement from March 14th through the 17th. Get the best seats and the best deals now. Single session tickets start at just $25. Or purchase all session tickets starting at $125 to see all 12 games. Atlantic 10 tickets now on sale at the American Express box office at Barclays Center or Ticketmaster.com.
Whether it's mom's smartphone, dad's tablet, Lauren's smartphone, or Kevin's smartphone, AT&T makes it affordable for the whole family to share data on all their devices. With AT&T Mobile Share, you can add a tablet for $10 a month. AT&T, rethink possible.
When it comes to the financial obstacles military families face, we understand. Our financial advice is geared specifically to current and former military members and their families.
Dad!
Life brings obstacles. USAA brings retirement advice. Call or visit us online. We're ready to help. Learn more with our free USAA Retirement Guide. Call 877-242-USAA.
The band plays on, but they need to get their team revved up just a little bit. Down eight are the Rams. Take a look at the AP poll, top 25, powered by Ram Trucks.
There's been a lot of upsets so far today, and VCU is hoping they're not one of them. Just look at those numbers. Good to see Butler won today. Arizona lost.
Well, we'll catch you
UCLA
up.
UCLA this week.
You betcha. AT&T at the half. Brent Stover, Steve Lapis, Abdul Nabi and John Rothstein. They're all going to give you the latest scores highlights from around the world of college basketball. Tune in to AT&T at the half.
That's a big job for Brett Stover to get everybody in line up there on that set.
He can do it.
Well, yeah, here's the game right here. LaSalle points in the paint, 22-16. But then again, they also lead the fast breaks, 10-3. LaSalle leading in the critical categories.
Vandenberg on Galloway. Give it up to Duren. They want to stretch the clock. It's now at 10. Mills for three, way off. Another rebound for Reddick.
I'm going to go back inside to Graham or Reddick.
Melvin Johnson on the drive. Off balance, that won't go. Zach the rebound.
It still was a good play by Johnson getting in the paint. A little bit out of control, but that's the way he plays. He had 8 first half points against Richmond. He kept the Rams in the game. Last time down to Sal. Didn't get a really good shot. See if they can do a little better here as you see the foul on Theus with 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Galloway happy to take it down, and these guys seemingly ready to wreak havoc on havoc.
Well, you'll see right here that LaSalle is able to break the trap. They started coming up the trap, but they got the ball away quick enough to the middle. We talked about that in the open. It's getting the ball to the middle of the court so that you can have numbers, have spacing. It's easier said than done when you're playing against these quick guys from VCU.
Galloway misses the first. Daniels will come in. Johnson take a seat. Duren will take a rest. Taylor Dunn with his first minutes. Redshirt junior, State College, Pennsylvania, by way of Winthrop. Galloway's 1-for-2. He's got 11.
Boy, look how quick Fias gets the ball into the front court. Graham has 3 points so far in the first half. Sal's done a really good job of shading to him. Keeping the ball out of his hands.
Second straight game with struggles in the first half. Can't answer there, but Graham gets the rebound. Back up on Zach Block. One more time, he walks. That's good defense by the big man.
That was very good defense. What Graham was trying to do, he went the other side to get the foul. And Zach went straight up with both hands, and then, as you see Galloway coming over on the other side, Graham picked up his pivot foot. Really good defense by LaSalle.
Threw it away. Had an open Peterson.
Yep. I tell you, Mills not able to break it, but you'll see right here, you'll see as soon as the trap comes, Mills picks up his dribble and he's throwing it to get rid of it quickly. A little bit too much English on it. But that's what you have to do. You have to get rid of the ball quick before the trap occurs.
Seventh turnover for the Explorers. Graham trying to take Galloway.
You see, when Graham's playing, he's playing against Galloway. They're almost the same size, but Galloway is actually a guard defensively. Graham's playing as a forward.
He's ready.
And they're going to get DJ Peterson on that, on the push.
And that will send him to the line.
We'll see a long rebound. You'll see Graham, or sorry, Reddick going after the ball. Peterson got his legs tied up, and it really was not a sort of a cheap foul, but he did. He did get tripped.
Reddick will take it. Shock and smart.
Duren back in the game.
Can't get the free throw, the long rebound. Graham can't get that to fall.
Well, Zach didn't start the game because they needed help guard-wise, but he's doing a good job inside.
Peterson, that's long.
Wow, that's not a shot you want to take with under a minute with a 9-point lead. It's important right now for VCU to get a good attempt at the basket and have a good possession.
Look to Reddick on the block. Zach, another block. It will stay with VCU.
That is really good defense by Zach. He's playing smart. He's not even jumping on these defensive plays. He's just playing good, solid defense. You see Duren go back out.
Dunn checks in for him. 11 on the shot clock. Daniels back deep. 8 on the shot clock. In the paint, off balance, can't get the roll. Zach, another rebound.
Good shot at the basket, good drive by Theus, but Zach is just a vacuum cleaner on the boards here in the last 5 minutes.
Galloway, 1 second.
That's an offensive.
Offensive foul, he pushed off on Graham.
It's a good call, Galloway sizing him up. Little push off.
Shaka Smart and his Rams 1-4 this season when they trail at half. And the refs gathering at midcourt to take a look at this last play and discussing exactly what happens as we have triple zeros on the clock. Little push off from Galloway. And they are going to the monitors as we take a look at when that call was made. See if we can see with the clock. Whistle.
Yeah, there was time on the clock.
Maybe 0.3.
Chenault. Well, you'll see right here the time. And there's the chicken wing right there. You see it.
Yeah, but the call's not made yet. Now the call's made.
There was about 5/10 of a second left.
Let's see what they decide. Over the last 7:56 of this half, a 15-2 run by the Explorers.
I was off a tenth. So 0.4 of a second. That's
we
a good
split
call.
It. You had five, I had three. We'll go 0.4.
We'll do that.
Just to keep everyone happy. That's right. We all compromise here. You see the record? 13-5, their best in a lot of years.
We're in Virginia, not in Washington. We should be compromising.
All right, we got 0.4. What does VCU have to do?
They have to throw it up quick to Reddick. They have to get the Reddick. He's got to shoot it crazy.
And he lost the handle, didn't get off in time. So VCU and Shaka Smart have a few things to talk about. Dr. John Giannini loves what his Explorers did coming in on the road after an upset of Butler on Wednesday night. They're trying to do it again. A back-to-backer. They lead 34-25 in Richmond. We'll be back at the half after this.
You come to LaSalle ready to be challenged by new ideas, to advance your education within the tradition of the Christian Brothers, to better identify the values that will help define your life. Along the way, you'll find common ground within a strong community and learn what the LaSallian promise means to your career and your future. It's a journey unlike any other. Never stop exploring. LaSalle.
Get NBA League Pass right now from DirecTV and don't miss a minute of live NBA action. NBA League Pass delivers games on TV, online, and mobile. That's right, you get the games on all platforms. Watch live action wherever you are and see the big NBA stars shine in big games throughout the season. Check out a free trial of NBA League Pass January 21st to the 27th. For more information, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to directtv.com/NBA.
Filing my federal taxes online last year was not a good experience. They said it would be free, but it cost me.
Bait and switch.
I deserve better, so I'm using TaxAct.
TaxAct.com.
Their code is like mine.
Integrity.
They mean what they say.
Simplicity.
It's fast and easy. And free.
That's value.
That's why I'm using
TaxAct.com.
All e-filable federal forms are free. TaxAct.com. It's how we act.
Attention parents and grandparents of young children. Gerber Life is accepting applications.
You'll always know your exact output. The new 2012 Proform Tour de France. Now that you're ready to change the way you train, call or go online today to get the newly advanced Proform TDF with zero down plus free upgrade on rush shipping.
Attention parents and grandparents of young children. Gerber Life is accepting applications for their affordable grow-up plan. The grow-up plan gives your child $10,000 in whole life insurance protection now, then doubles automatically to $20,000 later at no extra cost. Free information will be sent to parents and grandparents who call now. Help give your child a head start for just pennies a day. Don't wait. Call now for free information.
Call 1-800-523-3104. Call now.
VCU fans in full voice, but they need their team to get going. They trail by nine, does VCU, against LaSalle as they come in after a Wednesday upset over Butler, looking to do it again.
They really are. I think the people thought this may be a pretty one-sided game, VCU, but there's some great guards from LaSalle. This is a guard matchup. Got to get some of the bigger guys in the game for VCU.
And the guards have got it done on the fast break. Take a look at the highlights that we have from the first half.
Now, Duren did an excellent job early on getting the ball in the middle of the court and then taking advantage of the switch. I think that is so important. Duren in the first half scored 9 points in the first 6 minutes of the game. Didn't score the rest of the half, but controlled the offense.
Take a look at what they've done on the stats. Reeled in by Bass Pro Shops.
Man, I tell you, you know, the only neat thing that doesn't really mean anything is that second line. This one right here means nothing because it's 2 for 7. Every other, the hustle points down at the bottom, the points in the paint, the fast break points, all going the way of LaSalle. And that's usually the way it goes for VCU.
Reddic was dominant in the first half, 14 points early on, but his last points came at the 9:33 mark. And Treveon Graham, 1 for 7, his second first half of miserable.
Well, you're right. I mean, these are the top two leading scorers. Reddic getting it done. Graham had 0 points in the first half against Richmond, and he has 3 here in the first half against LaSalle. So really setting the scene right now for this game, being down by 9. VCU is going to try to get the ball into Graham and Reddic. I mean, that is a no-brainer. Now LaSalle has to be poised. They have to take care of the basketball and continue to be aggressive as they're on the road.
Well, you and I saw Charlotte and Xavier on Wednesday night. Xavier took 22 more shots than Charlotte and lost by 7. Tonight, in the first half, VCU has taken 3 more shots than LaSalle. They trail by 9.
And you heard Shaka Smart. We asked him today about what the key to the game is. And, you know, he gave us a couple of keys, and then he said, actually, I know this sounds crazy, but we got to make some shots. The team that makes shots is going to win, and so far, VCU has not been able to do that.
Reddic high on the block. Daniels with 10 on the shot clock. Peterson on him, lost the handle. Reddic, corner, fadeaway, got it. He makes it work.
That's not how it was drawn up, but it works. And now you see havoc. This is when they come after you. They pick up the ball. But remember, LaSalle's playing with 4 guards in the game right now. Zach is their big guy. Usually he's sitting on the bench. So LaSalle has a lot of ball handlers to try to alleviate havoc.
Mills with the youth. Short-armed it. Daniels the other way to Theus. Into the paint. Off the glass. And Dr. John wants to settle it down.
You know, you talk about points off turnovers and fast break points. LaSalle was doing better in the first half than VCU. But VCU picking it up, 4 straight unanswered points.
Find it?
Yeah.
All right, another one just like that. Right in the old bucket. Good toss. See, that's much better. That was good. You had your shoulder pointed, you kept your eyes on your target. Let's do it again, watch me. Just like that one.
The durability of the Volkswagen Passat. Pass down something he will be grateful for.
Good arm.
That's the power of German engineering.
Back to you.
Today, Jason is here to volunteer to help those in need. When a twinge of back pain surprises him, morning starts in high spirits, but there's a growing pain in his lower back. As lines grow longer, his pain continues to linger. But after a long day of helping others, he gets some helpful advice. Just who Aleve have the strength to keep back pain away all day? Today, Jason chose Aleve. Just 2 pills for all-day pain relief. Try Aleve D for strong all-day-long sinus and headache relief.
When you're a kid, you don't know much about housing markets. You don't know that home ownership builds communities. And you certainly don't know that owning a home contributes to higher self-esteem and better test scores. You just know that home is where you belong. It's where you play, grow, and learn. The National Association of Realtors wants you to know that home ownership matters to our families, our neighborhoods, and our country. Learn more at houselogic.com/homeownership.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible.
4-point run to start for VCU. Let's revisit the keys to the game and see how they're doing.
Well, LaSalle done a very nice job taking care of the basketball. Only 9 turnovers. The rebounds were even, so that was not a big deal. But VCU has not, he's only got 5 points off of fast breaks and 10 points off turnovers. They need to get those numbers up, create a little bit more of a tempo. And VCU finally starting to get the ball inside a little bit here in the second half.
Salle inbound. The Havoc presses on. They're up and break it.
LaSalle, with those four guards, had no problem breaking that press.
Peterson looked down low, stolen by Reddick.
Two wide open plays. There's two bad passes by LaSalle. Those are open plays. You throw a good pass. That's 4 points for LaSalle. Let's see if VCU goes inside to the big fella Reddick or gets Graham in the game.
Mr. Graham short. Reddick tried to keep it alive. Knocked it out of bounds.
They're going to say that was off Durham. I think he barely hit it after it hit off Graham's hand.
So it will stay with the Rams.
It's a big possession for VCU, and probably even a bigger one for LaSalle because they have to have a stop. VCU needs to continue going to the basket. Put the three-point jumper away and go to your bread and butter because you got the size advantage against this LaSalle team.
Theus on the drive. Graham! No, it's Brandenburg from the corner. And Rob Brandenburg for three makes it a two-point game. 7-0 run by the Rams.
That was really well executed by VCU. Good dribble drive by Theus. And then the pop out for the jumper.
Galloway, way deep, it's short. Not sure that's the shot Dr. John wants.
VCU, the good dribble penetration. You have three guys collapsing, staying away from allowing VCU to get the easy points in the paint, and then the pop out for the open jump shot. And once again, big play by Theus, creating off the penetration.
Penetrates again. Corner, Daniel steps in and buries. Wall tied up at 34. They've erased a 9-point halftime deficit.
And it is loud in here. It is very loud.
Duren into the paint. Whistle on Graham.
It's great to watch two super point guards run their team, Duren and Theus. Both of them small guards that do a good job of dribble penetration and taking their team and putting them on the shoulders. Theus, two very good passes to get open jump shots. Duren trying to calm the crowd down by getting in the paint.
Galloway on Theus. Gets help from Reddick. Stolen. Can't save it.
Well, he was lucky on that one because that is a fast break pass or a fast break play by Theus. You see right in the passing lanes. And this crowd is really into the game. And it's hard to hear yourself think in this place.
At the Siegel Center, 861 winning percentage in 13 seasons.
Some pretty impressive numbers. Seven on the shot clock as Duren takes it in. Turnover. This is a layup. Highlight reel.
Weber. Touched, but Duren didn't want to run into him. Is this Havoc?
This is what VCU does. They turn you over and they score on the other end. Weber with a 48-inch vertical leap really didn't do anything special, just put the ball in the basket. But VCU now with a 2-point lead and the ball.
Their first lead since 7:34. Of the first half.
Oh,
Brandenburg off balance, and he'll go to the line, and he lost the shoe. The shoes are coming off Brandenburg. The wheels are coming off the Explorers. They haven't scored in the second half. They trail by four.
We didn't always watch football at Buffalo Wild Wings.
So great to see you guys outside the office.
So you brew your own beer?
Yeah, for you, bratwurst beer, and this one's a secret. Drink up. This one's ready in 2 minutes.
Protect the football. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Want to know what I did in the last 5 hours? I played a round of golf. And then I read a book while teaching myself how to play guitar. Ran 10 miles while knitting myself a sweater. Jumped out of a plane. Finally, I became a ping pong master while recording my debut album. How you ask? 5 hour energy. I get hours of energy now, no crash later. Wait to see the next 5 hours.
Yeah, we're gonna need another wall. What's the number for props?
Take a note, make a call, all on the same screen. LG Optimus G.
Relax.
Available on AT&T.
VCU with a 13-0 run to start the second half, and they lead by 4, 38-34. And how are they doing? You see Theus with the ball. He's gonna dribble in here, and then you're gonna see Daniels come out over here, and you're gonna see the ball swing quickly for a wide open jump as Wright goes after Daniels. You'll see right over here is where you're gonna, oh, sorry, you're gonna see Daniels bring up the pump fake, get right out, get two. Nice play, all set up by Theus. Now you look at Theus, he only has, you know, 4 or 5 points. He's got 4 points and 4 assists, but he runs this team.
To go along with those numbers, 4 turnovers for LaSalle and a drought that has now lasted 6 minutes and 23 seconds.
LaSalle went on a 14-0 run in the first half to close out the first half. So the story is the guards are getting up and down. Take care of the basketball. Team that wins the points off turnover is going to win this game.
Brandenburg coming alive in the second half. Completes the three-point play, and it's a 14-0 run to start the second. Duren takes it across himself.
It's important for LaSalle to remember what got him the lead in the first half. Smart play going to the basket.
Galloway tries to draw the contact and misses the bunny. Weber! Blocking foul.
Garland not able to get over there quick enough to take the charge, but you can tell the momentum has swung right now over towards VCU. The aggressor are the Rams. LaSalle is playing on their feet, on their heels, not on the balls of their feet. This is a strong move. Garland not able to get over and take that charge.
He didn't go up for the full 48 on his vertical there. Missed his first free throw.
You know, I like on that play for the guy to stop and shoot that little pull-up jump shot.
Weber, a 75% free throw shooter. He's got 66 steals on the year.
Second in the country. Coming off the bench. It's a team that turns over the opponents 21 times a game. Right now, LaSalle has 12 turnovers.
VCU extends its largest lead of the game to 6.
Zach is the biggest guy on the court. You can throw it into him, but he's got to give it right back to the guard. I like that outlet.
As if they were listening to you.
He was towering. It looked like an eighth grader. We're playing with fifth graders. He's so big. Small guys in this game.
Galloway on the drive, off balance. That won't go, and Zach throws it out of bounds, trying to keep it alive. And the drought continues for the Explorers.
Galloway not taking over this team in the second half. Still, the Sal has not scored here in the second half. Almost 6 minutes gone. They have to get a stop here. You don't want to let this crowd just go crazy.
Reddic! He's got 18. Galloway with a nice dump to Zach. Couldn't handle it. Wheels in and finishes.
You can see the difference in size. Zach able to get his way down the low block. That's why it's important to have Zach in the game right now. You're going to have to get the ball to the basket. You got to look for the big fella.
Almost 6 minutes in before LaSalle scores in the second half. They trail by 6 after leading at the break by 9.
LaSalle, this is a team that's been together. They're resilient. 6 points on the road is not a big deal. They just have to make sure they have some defensive stops.
Graham still can't get it to go.
Back in, there you go, looking the big guy.
Mills. Weber knocked it away. Mills regathers. Zach the tip. Taken away by Theus.
Sal getting shots under the basket. They didn't go down in the first half for VCU. They're not going down in the second half for LaSalle.
Loose on the floor. Turnover. Garland the other way. Will take it himself and go to the line.
That is great body control by Garland. Saw that Theus was pulling up. Watch how he moves his body to the middle when he gets up in the air. Theus is set. Garland goes up and under. And now has a chance for the and one. And for the time being right now, LaSalle has quieted this capacity crowd. Wright's back in the game. You see Zach sitting down. I think he did a really good job while he was in there.
Garland looking for point number 5. Can't get it. The lead remains 4 for the Rams. Daniels, way deep.
We see Brad Redford shoot the ball out of favor. Good jump shooter from deep. Daniels has got a beautiful stroke.
He's got 77 on the year, 41% three-point shooter.
He's 6'4", nice two guard. He's a shooting guard. That's good size. He can raise up, but he's got a fluid stroke.
20-4, Rams run. DJ Haley comes in the game.
And LaSalle's still in it, only down 7. A lot of time left. And LaSalle's got to find that tonic to stop in VCU at the other end.
Duren. Back out to Galloway, who steps in. A couple of fakes and finger roll.
That was a great head fake by Galloway. Both of them. A little stutter step.
Graham in tight. That won't go. Duren the other way. Doesn't have the numbers. Doesn't matter to him. Probably should have.
That was a smart play by Theus. Now you watch, he'll set it back up. He's a guy, didn't look to shoot that 3. Now they're gonna spread out the Sal.
Corner, Brandenburg, step back, can't get it to go. Kept alive. Graham back to Brandenburg. That won't go. Wright collects ahead to Garland.
It's like a boxing match. We're going from side to side, and both teams playing really aggressive on both ends. I love this A-10 basketball.
Garland. And they're back within three.
That's what I call resiliency. When you come back, when you're down, when you're outscored 15-0 to start the half, and you come back and you're staying in the game. John Giannini's been talking about this team and how they play together and their chemistry.
Brandenburg in the paint. Back to Daniels for three. It won't go.
I'm going to get an over-the-back call right there.
DJ Haley will get rung up for that. A three-point lead for the Rams. 11 for Troy Daniels. Can you say deep? Daniels can.
You do a lot of thinking on a bike, about your life, family, your dreams. One of my dreams came to me on a bike, to open up my own shop. So what happens when you complete a dream? Well, you just start thinking of the next.
Mom's smartphone, Dad's tablet, Lauren's smartphone, or Kevin's smartphone. AT&T makes it affordable for the whole family to share data on all their devices. With AT&T Mobile Share, you can add a tablet for $10 a month. AT&T, rethink possible.
Come on, kid, I'm Drew Brees.
And I'm Harry.
Who?
From One Direction.
Dudes, won the Super Bowl.
Platinum album.
MVP.
On the cover.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Hey, man. Give me the Pepsi, and I'll get you a tryout.
Cool.
Hit me, Drew.
We're back in Richmond, a three-point lead for the VCU Rams, and what a run they've come on the second half.
And really, VCU had 8 points off turnovers in the first half. They have 10 already in the first 9.5 minutes of the second half, doing a great job playing good defense. The Salle's got to take care of that basketball.
10:47 remains. The Rams trailed by nine and came out with havoc. And now the Explorers have to answer one more time. Duren yet to score in the second half, and he started out like a house of fire.
He really did. And I think that right now he's got to get his squad under control, continue dribble penetration. But I'm impressed at how LaSalle has kept their poise in this environment. Tough place to play. Sal's done a pretty good job breaking the pressure. They move the ball quick. I talked about it with four guards in there. It's a heck of a lot easier.
On Galloway's cut. Nice feed from Wright.
And that was a good cut by Galloway, setting his man up off the pick. And getting to the basket very quickly.
15 for Galloway to lead the way for the Explorers. Reddick on the block on Wright. Spinning. That won't go. Foul called before the shot. But they will give him two shots.
Reddick's been carrying the load. Reddick and Daniels. Graham still, he's on the bench right now, but he's 1-for-10. Only 3 points. You know, you look at Shaka Smart. You know, you watch all the things about him in their Final Four run. This is a guy. He is one of the best up-and-coming coaches, and he is fun to talk to. Went to Kenyon College, you know, remembers guys from Kenyon. Coached in the A-10 before we coached Dayton with Oliver Purnell. Doesn't even have a seat on the bench because he stands up the whole time. The one thing I was impressed about when Scott Day, the SID, was talking to us today is he said he does not allow his players to do anything that he wouldn't do, whether it's conditioning, jumps in practice, and the players love this guy. Fun to play for.
Reddic has grown under his tutelage. 19 points, 9 rebounds tonight.
Senior on freshman.
9 on the shot clock. Garland on the drive. Had it blocked by Daniels. Four remaining on the shot clock.
You see Garland, good defense by Weber. And that's a smart play. Went behind the head to tip that ball.
Galloway behind a screen, had a wide open three, missed it, and Daniels couldn't collect. It will stay with the Explorers.
Sal caught a break because everybody left. There's two VCU players under the basket. Weber's got a height advantage on Duren.
Duren drives. Off balance, had it blocked, but Weber fouled him.
Talk about Theus on the other side of the court with VCU. I like the fact that Duren runs the show for LaSalle, realizes he's got to get the ball in the paint, takes a bigger defender and takes it to the basket. Weber called for the foul.
Happy to have him at the line where he shoots 77%. No question that the Explorers are ready for anything this year. You get run on like that, and now you sit 1 point back with a chance to tie after a 20-2 run?
And I think that's Doc Giannini. I mean, he's got guys that like playing together. They have good attitude. They got the I got your back attitude. And if you ever listen to a John Giannini huddle, he always says, hey, guys, I love you. I care about you guys. I got your back. But you got to do this, this, and this. And this team's listening, and they've nodded the score at 46.
He's an author of Court Sense, and his kids have some court sense now. Back to the sixth tie of the game, and now a chance to retake the lead.
Graham with another miss. 1 for 11. With 3 points.
Duren off balance. Zach the rebound. Garland. Nice fake.
That was a playground move by Garland. A little fake behind the back. Now it's VCU's turn to answer.
Graham can't get it. Got his own rebound. He'll go to the line. Frustration all night long for Graham.
You can look at his face. He's got frustration. But you'll see Zach, another rebound. I think he's played a marvelous game. Watch the fake behind the back pass. Garland takes it up over Graham. Graham went for the fake.
And now Graham will go to the line.
This may be what Graham needs, because sometimes you get to the free throw line, you feel a little bit more confident. You start feeling a little bit more, but that is only the fourth point. The reigning A-10 player of the week.
Can't tie it up. LaSalle with the ball in the lead. Inside 8.5 to play. Corner. Galloway. 18 for Galloway. As he salutes the crowd. Garland the rip. Making the trip. Galloway.
Who would have thought after VCU came out halftime on fire for shutting down LaSalle. LaSalle now going on their own roll.
Went up six, and now LaSalle is back up six.
Well, that's just a beautiful touch. Not enough extension by Brandenburg getting to the corner on Galloway. And then you'll see, you can see the steal by Garland, but the nice pass to Galloway.
A 15-2 run over the last four and a half. They have not beaten ranked opponents in consecutive games. You want to add those years up?
I think that was in the Tom Dole era.
Goodness gracious, since 1952, they're looking to shorten that streak tonight.
Yeah, there's a lot of game left. We said that in the first half. We said at the start of the second half, there's been a lot of runs. And now VCU is going to see if they can go on one of their patented runs. With that defense creating havoc, they could be combustible.
Brandenburg trying to feed Reddick. Had it knocked away by Galloway. And with 7:46, we'll take a TV timeout. Shaka Smart will try and figure things out one more time.
Find it? All right, another one, just like that. Right in the old bucket. Good toss.
See, that's much better.
That was good. You had your shoulder pointed, you kept your eyes on your target. Let's do it again, watch me. Just like that one.
The durability of the Volkswagen Passat. Pass down something he will be grateful for.
Good arm.
That's the power of German engineering.
Back to you.
This one means I'm a leader with highly specialized technical skills and college education. This one means I'm physically, mentally, and emotionally strong. And this one means I'm an officer. But what really matters is what they mean to everyone around me.
An Army officer inspires strength in others. Find out more at goarmy.com/officer. There's strong, and then there's Army strong.
When it comes to the financial obstacles military families face, we understand. Our financial advice is geared specifically to current and former military members and their families.
Dad!
Life brings obstacles. USAA brings retirement advice. Call or visit us online. We're ready to help. Learn more with our free USAA retirement guide. Call 877-242-USAA.
Back in Richmond, LaSalle up by six because they're figuring out how to do a break habit.
We talked about it. They play with four guards. And you'll see right here, Galloway. You'll see three guards that are in the picture right here. And then you'll see Zach. What's going to happen is as soon as this trap goes over here, Galloway is going to reverse the ball back to Duren and see if they can get the press. So ready? You see it coming over. Quick. The ball's got to be reversed to Duren, and then Duren will bring it down court to set up the offense. What happens is when you have forwards in the backcourt, guys that don't handle the ball too well, a lot of times there's turnovers.
Take a look at tonight's AT&T game summary.
And it's Galloway's coming on. He's over his average. Reddick is the guy for VCU. What we're not seeing in this is Graham has not produced. He's got 4 points. Points in the paint. Battle belongs to LaSalle. A lot of that's got to do with the drive to the basket.
You see the run. 10-1 at home. VCU has won 9 straight here at the Stuart Siegel Center. And Zach's going to get the foul out top. Not where you want your 7-footer to get a foul.
You know what? That was they were setting up the pick and pop. Not a bad foul. Zach's only has 2 personal fouls right now. This is a play that'll be called. It was called out of the timeout. Looking to try to get an open jump shot or drive to the basket.
Brandenburg short. Reddick can't get it. Zach the rebound.
I love the new possession arrow down at your corner of your screen. You see right down here that possession arrow. That'll keep you in tune. I don't think anybody else does that. It's great. CBS Sports Network coming up with innovative ideas, and that's going to be important especially in a game like this, a six-point lead with a lot of runs, Brad, to realize who's got the ball in a jump ball situation.
Peterson into the paint. Jump stop corner. Duren had the save. In trouble now that Theus on him. And they're going to call. They're going to call Theus, and he can't believe it.
And what really is a problem is there was only 3 seconds on the shot clock. He bailed out Duren because there was no place for him to go. As you'll see, Theus is playing good defense and actually could have been a hook on Duren.
Sixth team foul on VCU. Next one will send LaSalle to the bonus.
I think John Gemini has done a really good job using Zach in this game. He uses him in the outlet. He's done a good job on the offensive end and defensive end.
Galloway had the lane, couldn't get the roll off the glass. Reddic the jump down to Theus over the head. The lead is 4 for the Explorers.
It's a great pass by Reddic and a good cut to the basket by Theus. That is a design play. Theus feels he can beat his man, and he can turn him. He goes straight to the basket.
6 minutes to play. 4-point ball game. Durham, corner, Galloway. High arcing triple.
I know Galloway knocked that jump shot down, but you have to give a lot of credit to Duren for getting in the paint and collapsing that defense. So Galloway was wide open for that jump shot.
The lead is 7. Galloway with 23. Reddic on Zach, driving, had it blocked.
And what that does, when you have a good stop, if you're LaSalle, VCU doesn't have a chance to set up that full court havoc defense. And that's one of the tools in the toolbox to get this Rams team back into the game.
Duren to the rack, won't go. Daniels the other way, lost it. Galloway thought about it.
He was sizing Weber up. Smart play by Galloway.
Bring out Zach.
Having an offensive foul on Zach.
Mills wanted him to come out. Zach came out too quick and too strong. But I'm impressed with the big man's hands down low.
I tell you, he's done a great job on the defensive end. He's also crowded a number of rebounds on the offensive end to restart their offense. Now, Shaka Smart needs his team to get a big bucket in this possession.
Theus. Graham. Need him badly. That won't go. Reddic the rebound. He's got a double-double.
Graham hesitated on that jump shot because it was good defense by Galloway coming out and playing defense on him.
Daniels. In and out. Zach knocks it out of bounds. It will stay with VCU.
I like how Graham's fighting. He was the guy on the offensive board that was fighting Zach. You know, when you shoot and you struggle like Graham has struggled in this game, it's very easy to hang your head and not do the ordinary things you should be doing. On that possession, he kept it alive by going after it. Zach had to hit it out of bounds. This is a great matchup. Both guard-oriented teams. Good quickness on both ends of the court.
Graham, whistle, but count the basket. That may get him going. What is it they say? Shoot or shoot.
Shoot till you get hot and shoot till you get cold.
56-51. Treveon Graham has struggled all night long. A little runner and one. We'll be right back.
Wind power and torque. maximum capability and versatility, and comfortable seating for four, the off-road rated Terex 4 side-by-side. How can it get any better? How about no interest for 48 months or a $1,000 purchase incentive? Better. Right now, get no interest for 48 months or a $1,000 purchase incentive on all Terex 4s. Don't wait. This offer ends March 31st.
Regular appetizers, you'd be sharing them by now. Taco Bell's new Loaded Grillers. Appetizer taste of spicy wings, tasty skins, and beefy nachos. Each just 99 cents and wrapped up just for you.
It was designed to escape the ordinary. It feels like it can escape gravity. The 2013 C-Class Coupe. Starting at $37,800.
Hey, coming up next, professional bull riding. CBS Sports Network proud to present PBR. Built for Tough Series. WinStar World Casino Invitational from Oklahoma City. Pure PBR. Next on CBS Sports Network. Now let's take a look at tonight's U.S. Postal Service game reset.
Hey, look at that. The possession arrow with LaSalle. Both teams. LaSalle on the bonus. VCU on the verge, but I think more importantly, Treveon Graham able to get going offensively with 4 minutes to go in the game, makes a beautiful drive to the basket. And what I said before, young kids need to look at this, at Graham. The sophomore didn't hang his head, was on the offensive board fighting. He hasn't quit, and that's the character that the Shaka Smart teams have. These guys fight to the finish. And you can't look at the numbers, you look at the end of the game, who won or lost.
Graham can't complete the three-point play, struggles from the line.
Once again, not able to have that havoc defense, full-court pressure defense, when you miss the shots.
Reddic to steal, and the break. He's got 21. On the offensive end, Reddic has almost single-handedly kept the Rams in this one.
Well, he did it on the defensive end, too. That was Reddic that poked the ball away from Zach.
Duren had it blocked. Foul call.
How about Duren? That is unbelievable. Duren taking it in there, but at the other end, you see Zach needs to go out after the ball. Reddic is a little bit smaller, a little bit more athletic. Pokes the ball away and then flushes it through.
That's what Shock said. There's not a whole lot this kid can't do. So athletic, so versatile, and he's showing it all tonight.
And that's saying something on a team that is so athletic and so versatile. You have to be athletic and versatile to be on this team.
Big miss for Duren at the line. 77% on the season. Weber back down. Daniels back in. Can't get the roll, missed them both. A three would tie.
I'd look right back at Graham and Reddic. Let's take it to the horses.
Graham into the paint. Got it! Down one.
That was a man's play. You can see the difference in his body, in his emotion. Graham's getting it going right now. It's important for the South.
On their feet at the stew. Whistle.
It's important for LaSalle to make a run and get something going. And the foul, really, for VCU took, bailed out LaSalle. As you'll see, Graham just taking Mills straight to the basket.
What do you always say? When you can't get the range outside near a shooter, take it to the hole.
And that's exactly what Galloway did here. To get to the free throw line to quiet the crowd. This crowd is as loud as any crowd that I have heard in recent memory. They get into it. 30 straight sellouts.
Galloway has 25 on the night. The lead back to three for the Explorers. Reddick threw it away.
Now that's an interesting graphic. Playing at home. Under 4 minutes with that havoc defense, you never know.
2:21 remains. They trail by three. Their largest second half deficit this season before tonight that they've come back to win has been four. They trailed by nine at the break.
Sal is going to take a little air of the ball and try to drive to the basket. They don't have it. Kick it back out for a jump shot.
Duren. Five on the shot clock to the glass. Gets the roll.
Still a two-possession game. But that's a great drive.
To Reddick. And he's fouled. Galloway went up with him. Reddick couldn't finish. What a feed.
That's a beautiful pass. Well, you see Duren taking it to the basket, but they don't sit on their heels. VCU gets it out quick. You see a beautiful pass from Theus to Reddick. That's the only thing that Reddick hasn't put through the basket this evening.
Big miss at the free throw line. Don't forget, coming up right after us, Pure PBR from Oklahoma City. Hope you'll stay with us.
Now, with it being a four-point game, the other thing LaSalle has going for him is you see in the right-hand corner under the clock, LaSalle has a possession arrow. So if you get tied up, you're still going to retain possession if you're LaSalle.
Weber on the foul. Crowd not happy with the call. And Duren will head to the line. Take a look at it one more time. What's your call? Ooh, a little elbow from Duren. Yeah, and a push.
I tell you, the way they've been, both teams have been playing, it's been very physical. I don't know if I'd call that foul in the beginning, but
I mean, Weber's not doing anything but running with it.
Yeah. Smart play by Duren, drawing the foul.
He gets the benefit of the call, makes the first. Makes it a five-point lead for the Explorers.
If LaSalle wins this game, it's going to be Duren, I think, is my MVP from the way he's been able to control the game, get in the lane, get Galloway open shots.
Missed the second.
VCU has two timeouts remaining. Get a quick shot, a score, or a turnover.
Graham lost the handle. Reddick couldn't collect it down low. Galloway has it. And they've got it across. 1:15 left and 22 left on the shot clock.
Now you're not going to foul with 16 seconds left. They've made their decision.
Down by five.
Lots of this time left. Just make sure you get a stop. Do not want to foul.
Galloway slipped and they call a foul on Theus.
And once again, the shot clock, Brad, was at 4 seconds. And Galloway was fighting to try to see if he can get something going. But I think that Theus hit his arm on him, but Galloway slipped. I don't think that was a foul. But once again.
Back-to-back go the Explorers' way.
Yeah. But you have to You can't foul when that shot clock is under 10.
Galloway has tied his season high with 26.
And that was an important free throw because now it's a three possession game. We said VCU has two timeouts left. Might look at Daniels getting a three.
Graham to the rim and fouled. Zach says, what did I do? 20 a whistle, Stephen. No one happy.
This is a good drive to the basket. I'm not sure where the foul was on that, but still, it's a tight game. It's a great drive by Graham. And the good thing is the VCU doesn't have to take a timeout now. The Graham has to make this so they can set up their havoc defense.
Weber will come back in. Daniels will sit on the defensive end. Johnson will come in, and Theus will sit.
Treveon Graham for the three-point opportunity.
To cut the lead to four. Graham does. PBR. Pure PBR from Oklahoma City right after this. If you're waiting for the rodeo, it's coming up next.
I'd foul. Well, I'd 34 seconds left. Now there's...
And they get Galloway. We'll get the rodeo in its entirety right after we get Havoc in its entirety.
You know what's hard at the end of the game when you're playing against LaSalle? Galloway shoots it at 75% from the free throw line. Duren 77, Garland 77, Zach 71, and Mills is 78. And then if you want to throw Peterson in there, he's shooting at 91%. So this is a team that it's tough to foul at the end of the game because they're such good shooters.
Well, they fouled a guy who has taken over tonight, a new season high at 27. And as they check back in, Galloway will shoot for a tie of his career high.
It's a double bonus, so he's going to get two shots.
He's got 28.
This is a big shot for LaSalle, too, because, you know, it makes it so they have to hit, VCU has to hit two three-point jumpers, or at least a total of six. Now the clock is the enemy for VCU.
We told you Richmond came back from down seven with 42 seconds to go on Thursday and a new career high for Galloway at 29. Graham, hand checked out top, and Garland will get the foul.
That is not what Doc Giannini wants. You do not want VCU to stop the clock. Now they have a chance to shoot two free throws with only 5 seconds and off the clock.
You see the three-point shooters. Down by six, it may become imperative. Graham good on the first.
With this defense, I think you try to make the second one and you play good solid half-court defense. If they get the ball to half-court, VCU should foul. Still got time, there's a lot of time left. If he makes it a four-point game. Possession arrow down in your right-hand corner is favoring LaSalle.
Guest in limited minutes checks in. Graham good on both. The lead is four for LaSalle.
LaSalle has to take care of the basketball because this is going to be tough defense.
Timeout called by the Explorers as Galloway gets in trouble and heads to the ref to say, did not I get pushed?
That is interesting because if you look, LaSalle has one timeout left. You see the little dash under LaSalle on the screen. You see this, Galloway gets trapped in the corner and he gets a dribble out. They call Peterson over in the right-hand corner, calls timeout. You see Peterson to watch. He'll go straight over to the official and call a timeout. A smart play by DJ Peterson.
Did he get pushed?
But I was going to say,
remaining silent.
LaSalle, if you remember the start of the second half, they had to call two straight timeouts because of the defensive pressure and the turnovers as VCU went on their 13-0 run to start the second half. They've been able to keep two of those timeouts and then were able to use that. If, you know, if the game would have gotten out of hand earlier, they might not have had any timeouts. That would have been a turnover.
See the reset. LaSalle with the possession arrow. 23.8 left on the clock. Pure PBR coming up from Oklahoma City. You'll get it in its entirety. Richmond, Virginia. A-10 battle, VCU and LaSalle. LaSalle trying to pull back-to-back upsets of ranked teams for the first time in their history since 1952.
Got to get the ball up court, and I would foul right now.
Probably Galloway?
You got to foul. I don't care. You got to foul. I mean, the clock is your enemy. You lose 5 seconds on that if you're VCU. You got to foul immediately as they get the ball over half court.
So Galloway will head to the line already with a new career high, adding to it with each point. He's got 30. Take a look at the A-10 standings. LaSalle would improve to 4-2. VCU fall to 4-2 with back-to-back losses. And Butler would remain the only team atop the A-10 with one loss.
A lot of teams at 4-2. And it's a great league. This is arguably one of the most competitive leagues top to bottom in the country.
Garland lets fly. That won't go. Tipped back out. Graham lets fly. That won't go. LaSalle has the rebound and 1.1 left on the clock. And they're going to do it.
I think many people wondered if LaSalle under Coach Doc John Giannini could get over that Butler win. And from day, he said, enjoy it tonight after that Butler game. And let's act like we're supposed to be here. We're supposed to win these games. And I think he's proven to the people back in Philadelphia that his team is for real. He's done a great job in his tenure at LaSalle.
Duren was 16. And LaSalle has done it. 69-61. On Wednesday, they take down number 9 Butler. And on Saturday, they take down number 19 VCU. They withstand a 20-2 run in the second half. And Dr. John Giannini has got it done for the first time since 1952.
Now, they withstood the pressure, only committed 14 turnovers on the game.
So Dr. John has got it done. He said his team was good. He said, talk to me in March. People are talking about him now. Our score from the Stuart Siegel Center, 69-61. For Steve Wolf and our entire crew, I'm Brad Johansson. For scores, highlights, features, and more, go to CBSSports.com. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Now let's take you out to Oklahoma City for Pure PBR, the Built Ford Tough Series WinStar World Casino Invitational. Thanks for joining us, everyone.